The shooting happened around 10 o'clock this morning.
5 Emmys, 1 for live reporting.
Behind me, you can see Georgia power crews working right now.
I won an Edward R. Murrow Regional Award.
He's been a leader in the civil rights movement in Birmingham.
Yeah, I've got many Emmy nominations.
The first day of testimony in Langford's trial.
Now, I was pretty crazy. When I think about that night, I decided I was going to commit suicide. I was gonna die. I lost my job in Atlanta because of the drugs. And it took me a long time to get to that. I always blamed them.
Depression was an issue for me, and self-medication became the way to deal with it.
I had been married since 1989, and it was not a good fit. That just added to the depression, and you know, I gave up. The drugs seemed to give me the ability to keep pushing on and pushing through. Instead of, you know, moving up the ladder, I have been coming down the ladder. And Birmingham, after working in 3 top 10 markets, you know, Birmingham was 39, 40. My daughter decided she wanted to come and live with her dad. So, you know, I kind of straightened up on that, and she came and she stayed with me, and you know, it was pretty good. But then one Sunday, the Sunday before her birthday, our mother came. And when I found out, it just devastated me. And I decided at that point I didn't have a purpose. My life's purpose was gone. I had a gas fireplace in the basement. I said, what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn the gas on. I'm going to go down there. I'm going to get drunk. Benadryls will help put me to sleep. And I'll go to sleep in front of this fireplace. And that's what I did. I woke up the next morning pissed off. I will tell you that. I didn't die. I should have.
It makes me sad and upset and a bunch of things. And that's why I come to church.
There is a reason for me to be here. There is a higher reason. There is a purpose for me to be here. And I think that purpose is to tell this story.
Roy, what's your next day and the next day look like? What are your plans for the future?
Well, I don't know about tomorrow, because I live life one day at a time.
You know, it's tough on the kids, because what happened to me was very public. You know, it didn't just happen in Birmingham. It happened all across the country, because I've worked all over the country. So I've been clean for 2 years and 3 months, and in fact, I became a sponsor. Where I'm sponsoring a young man.
I'd like to get back on the air again. I think I can provide some hope for people if they can see me as a person who went all the way down there and was able to rise back up.
You know what? What I've learned is that I do have a purpose. There had to be a reason that kept me alive. You know, I'm living life on life's terms, and that means that it's not all puppy dogs and rainbows. There are still things I gotta go through.